Welcome to this tutorial on enabling multilingual support in the BuddyBoss app using the WPML plugin. Offering your app in multiple languages not only improves accessibility and engagement, it also supports inclusivity and helps meet Apple and Google's policy requirements for launching apps in certain countries. In this video, we'll walk you through how to manage your language settings, adding, editing, and removing languages, in addition to also how to configure the language behavior for a seamless, localized user experience. I'll also show you the revamped build request screen designed to really streamline your workflow when creating new apps. Let's dive in. From your WordPress dashboard, go to BuddyBoss App Translations. Click Add Language to open the drop-down menu. Everything listed here comes with built-in translations, so you won't need to manually translate each string, but I'll show you what this looks like in just a second. For this tutorial, we'll use French as our example. Select it, then click Add to register the language in your app. Once added, you'll see a list of translatable strings specific to that language. As I mentioned earlier, most strings are already translated, but if you want to tweak the wording or update certain phrases, you can absolutely do this. The first way to do this is to edit directly in the backend. With French selected, we can use the search bar and look for a string that you wish to translate. For example, instead of group, I will change this to something else. Enter your preferred translation in the text box, then click Save Changes to apply it. Your second option is to edit via the CSV file. Click Download CSV to export all the translation keys and values. You can then open this file in any spreadsheet editor, make your changes and save it. Return to the dashboard and click Upload CSV to re-import your updated translations. If you ever need to remove a language, scroll to the bottom of a translations page and click Delete. Then confirm the prompt. This will permanently delete the language and any of the associated translations. Now let me quickly show you something important on the menus page. Go to BuddyBoss App, Menus. When you add a new language, the system will automatically create a menu placeholder. Click on the French menu and then click Create Default Menu Structure. From here, you'll need to manually configure the tab bar, header bar, and the more menu for each language. This ensures fully localized navigation, enhances user experience, and gives you the flexibility to tailor labels and your menu content for each audience. Now that we've translated the app interface and set up the menus, the next step is to translate your actual content, like posts, pages, and custom post types, using the WPML plugin. WPML lets you create duplicate versions of your content in different languages, so when a user switches languages on the app, they'll automatically see the translated version. First, go to WPML Languages. Here, you can add new languages or change your site's default language. Click Add Language, select French, then click Save. Once that's done, head over to the WPML Translation Management. This is where you'll handle translating your site's content. You can select a specific post or page, or select all of them and click Translate your content. Next, choose whether you want to review translations before they go live, then click Translate. If you'd rather have everything done automatically, there is an option at the top called Translate Everything Automatically. Turn that on and a pop-up will appear. Choose Translate My Entire Site. This will automatically translate all your existing content and any new content you create moving forward. Keep in mind that translating content does consume WPML credits. Agree to the terms, then click Continue. You'll be asked again if you'd like to review translations before they're published. Once you make your choice, click Translate Everything Automatically. For now, I will only translate selected posts. At this point, WPML will generate translated versions of your content for each selected language. You can still edit individual pages in each language without affecting the others. The same applies to the BuddyBoss app pages. However, app block tiles need to be translated manually for each language. This ensures that when a user selects a different language, like French, they'll automatically see a translated version for each app page and for block titles. I'll link our WPML documentation in the description below. Now, for all this to take effect on the app, you'll need to submit a new build. Let me also show you the new improvement that we've made to the request build page. Go to BuddyBoss App, Build, then click Request Build. In step one, the build settings haven't changed. You'll still choose your platform and whether it's for a release or a test app. And if you're already familiar with this step, then great, you're good to go. But here's where it gets exciting. Step two has been completely redesigned based on your feedback. We've streamlined the layout by removing unnecessary fields and focusing on what really matters. At the top of each app overview, you'll now see a new advanced setting link. Clicking this opens a pop-up where you'll manage your Apple and Google permissions, enabling or disabling them before submitting each build request. This gives you more control on how your app functions on each platform, and we will further increase permissions in the future. Next up is your app overview section, which is now much cleaner as you'll see the icon, name, and build type. Under the iOS and Android settings, you'll find all the technical details grouped clearly together, including the build version, version code, whether push notifications and in-app purchases are enabled. And of course, one of the most useful additions to this page is the new languages section. There's a go-to translations link that opens the full translation menu in a new tab, making it easier to make any last minute edits. Below that, you'll also see a list of all the languages that you've added to your app. You can select which ones to include in a build. Your default language will be locked and pre-selected. And then here's the best part. The BuddyBoss app will now remember your previous selections, so that next time you request a build, your preferred languages will already be checked and there'll be no need to set them again. This revamp is all around clarity, speed, and control, so you can confidently manage your app's updates, and it will give us the ability to add new permissions in the future. Once everything looks good, click Send Build Request and wait for your build to be processed. Now let's switch to the app to see how these translations appear in the front end. We're now on the sign-in screen, and you can already see the translated text that we've updated in the back end. Let's go ahead and sign in. As we move through the app, you'll notice other areas are also translated. Menus, buttons, and the other interface elements are now fully localized in French. This gives your users a seamless, personalized experience from the very first screen. If we head over to the blogs directory and open a blog post, you'll also see the post content itself has also been translated, thanks to WPML. Users can switch their preferred languages directly in the app. To do this, go to Settings, Language. Here, they'll see a list of available languages, including the French option that we've just added. Once a language is selected, you'll be asked to reset the app, and all UI elements will be updated, delivering a fully localized experience. Now, one tip when offering multilingual support is to check your fonts. If your branding font doesn't support special characters, then you may see blank boxes or strange symbols. To avoid this, the app will either fall back to a system font or display a warning message to alert you. Either way, you'll be covered, and your app will remain readable and visually consistent across all languages. Adding multilingual support is a major step forward into making your app more inclusive and globally accessible. Whether you're expanding new markets or just looking to offer a better experience for your diverse audience, multilingual support ensures your content reaches users in the language they're most comfortable with. We hope this tutorial helped you get started, and if you found it useful, give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and let us know in the comments below which languages that you're adding to your app.